Hi, and welcome to my Capstone project. Today we'll be going through my CI/CD pipeline, as well as all the technologies that go into it. This video will start by going into each individual technology and showing the skills required to build the pipeline. Once we're done that, we'll show a live demo of how the pipeline works by completing a live build. I appreciate your time, thank you for watching, and without further ado, let's get into it. The first technology that we will cover today is Linux. Linux and DevOps go hand in hand. At the core of the majority of enterprise IT projects, you'll find Linux involved in some way, shape, or form. Linux is highly customizable and it scales well. From a DevOps frame of mind, these two characteristics are very valuable as they allow us to come up with versatile solutions so that business teams, development teams, and operations teams can deliver their product as quickly as possible without sacrificing quality. In this example, we'll SSH into our EC2 instance and check the bashrc file to make sure our path is configured for our new user program so that when we write new user on the command line, the program will run as expected. The new user program will allow us to add a new user as well as assign them to a group. Once we run the program, we'll make sure our user was created and assigned to the right group. The next two technologies that we'll be covering are Git and GitHub. Git allows teams to manage changes in their code in an easy and effective manner. Both teams, big and small, will be able to work on different parts of the project while submitting their code to the same repository. This allows all team members to have the most up-to-date version of the code base so that they can make their changes accordingly. In this example, we'll pull our code from GitHub, make sure the correct files are in the gitignore file, make a change to the README, and then push these changes back to GitHub. We'll be right back. Before any good project can come to fruition, it must be planned out thoroughly. The same is true in a DevOps pipeline. We must go through each section, part by part, and make sure everything's going to work as efficiently and effectively as possible. Architectural diagrams help us to achieve this. We can visualize the project, go through piece by piece, and make sure everything's going to work as expected. The architectural diagram works as a blueprint before the software actually gets rolled out. As the name suggests, infrastructure as code allows us to define and deploy infrastructure through code. Similar to how we expect our source code to deliver the same result each time it's run, we can deliver the exact same environment when running infrastructure through code. This allows teams to deploy their infrastructure rapidly and reliably, especially as the project continues to grow. In this example, we'll use a YAML template in CloudFormation to deploy a VPC with two public and two private subnets. We'll then create an EC2 that uses that VPC and SSH into it. Docker allows developers to put their code in virtual containerized environments. This means that their code will run on any machine without any compatibility issues. This makes the code simpler to use for the user and less troubleshooting work on the developer's end. In this example, we'll pull a Docker image from Docker Hub and then run it locally. Earlier, we discussed Docker and containerization. With containers, teams can package up their services neatly. For larger projects, this usually means many containers will be running at once. This isn't an issue, but it brings up the question of how will these containers talk to each other? How can we debug issues with all these containers running and monitor what's happening? This is where Kubernetes comes in. In this example, we'll set up a local Kubernetes cluster, run our code, and deploy our app to that cluster. Once that's complete, we'll set up a new cluster on Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service and deploy our app to it. Now that we've touched on all the ingredients of what needs to go into our pipeline, we can run through a demo. In the following video, we'll build the project with Jenkins and then test the pipeline. The first step of our Jenkins file is to clone the project from GitHub. In the second stage, we'll clean up any images that have been rebuilt with the same name, removing the dangling image. We'll then build our Docker image. Once the Docker image is built, we can push it back to Docker Hub. Our Kubernetes deployment file is configured to always pull the image again, so any new changes to the image will be pulled into EKS. We then update our kubeconfig file and apply our deployment. If the whole build is successful, Slack will send us a message. We will now test our Jenkins pipeline. The first step in the test will be to update our source code and push the change to GitHub. Our GitHub webhook will send a message to Jenkins, letting it know to trigger a new build. During the Jenkins build, a new Docker image will be built that includes the new code changes. This new image will then be pushed to Docker Hub. Kubernetes will then pull the updated image from Docker Hub and deploy it to our EKS cluster. We then should be able to see the changes on our live website.